Anyone fortunate enough to have seen just one of Guizhou province's many jaw-dropping bridges would immediately be struck by its majestic beauty and almost fairy tale-like quality. Here, you'll find some of the longest, highest, and technically advanced bridges ever built, inspiring as much wonder as towering beanstalks and castles in the clouds. Today, nearly half of the world's top 100 highest bridges are in Guizhou, with over 30,000 bridges either completed or under construction here. Between its truss arch bridges, continuous reinforced concrete rigid frame bridges, suspension bridges, single tower cable stayed bridges, double tower cable stayed bridges, triple tower cable stayed bridges, and concrete-filled steel tube arch bridges, Guizhou boasts almost every type of bridge ever conceived. As history enters a new stage, these technologically advanced bridges have continuously leaped across valleys, canyons, and ravines, connecting Guizhou's precipitous terrain with flat, high-speed thoroughfares.
This是悬索桥施工过程中架设的临时施工便道。 是大桥阻缆施工的一个操作平台。阻缆牵引过程中需要安装拖轮来滚动，施工人员行走过程中就会S型的绕着走，就像猫走路一样，所以叫猫道。
These two catwalks spanning the Zangke River Bridge represent the basic pathways through which the two main cables will pass. The catwalks ensure the precise installation of the main cables, which are the most critical load-bearing parts of a suspension bridge. However, once installed, they cannot be adjusted or replaced during the 100 years of its design life. Though the catwalk appears to consist of just two layers of steel mesh, it can actually support the weight of a truck. The two main cables of the bridge, each weighing 11,741 tons, are about to be unspooled across the catwalks.
姚姐准备。姚姐到位。姚姐，也当手绳开始。
The main cables are divided into individual strands, with each strand's head attached to a traction cable, which pulls them across the river by a winch on the opposite bank. The entire process is like threading a giant needle. Thicker cables are pulled by thinner ones, until gradually the main cable is set in position.
单幅主缆的这个长度是1908米，单幅的这个主缆由199股这种锁骨组成，每一股又有91丝。如果把全桥主缆的钢丝全部连接起来，这个总的长度可以绕地球1.7圈。
Today, the first strand of the main cable is about to be pulled. Since its final position will serve as a reference for the remaining 198 strands, it's called the baseline strand. Installing the baseline strand is critical to the entire cable installation, so each step must be carried out with complete and absolute precision. For good luck, the workers escorting it have tied red banners to the strand head.
大家好，来，一二三，走。一二三，大家好，来，一二三。哎，因为是第一次嘛，还没第一次，然后他说有导轮，他都要调一下的。好，刚好的通知，刚好的通知。对面山上，从这边从拿永安开车的话，过去都是个把小时都可以到家。 以前因为小时候很少，因为在外面读书嘛，然后就这个假期回来也很少出来玩。后面都是来这里修这个桥以后才长时间在这，看到确实景色还是挺好的。哎，要讲的要修路，修了路通了，那自然资源些都方便了，嗯，对家乡肯定是很好的。
3 hours later, the baseline strand reaches the opposite tower. The strands are then fixed at the top of the two main towers using saddle anchors, and both ends are secured with massive alloy bolts to anchors on either bank. But the more critical task of adjusting the strand still needs to be done. Strangely enough, this next step can only be done in the quiet of night.
Mario，慢点，慢点，现在慢点。举不举杯调锁啊？现在这个温度，可以，可以，可以哈。这个风还比较小，应该不影响。哎，因为这个基准锁的这个精度要求非常的高，所以一般这种调锁。 都是在每一天的温度最低的时候，大概就在往凌晨12点左右的时候开始调。哎，调锁主要调整它的这个线型，也就是我们采用仪器来给它随时的监测。一般是调整锁骨的话，哎，会调3到5天。Through
the coordination of instruments on and under the bridge, constant adjustments must be made to ensure every section and fixed point of the baseline strand is positioned precisely. The adjustments made in the next few days are critical for the bridge's core components and will minimize the potential impact of any adverse environmental conditions. Once the adjustments are made, the installation moves into high gear. The 199 strands will soon be combined to form the main cable, essentially giving the Zangke River Bridge its backbone. Almost all of the suspension bridge's weight is supported by its two main cables. Upon completion, the Zangke River Bridge will be able to withstand at least 25,000 tons. These cables are the culmination of modern bridge technology, testing the limits of industrial manufacturing in terms of strength, flexibility, waterproofing, and corrosion resistance. In the past, we had to rely on imported cables for our bridges, but now the main cables for this bridge are domestically produced and are even manufactured right here in Guizhou. But before the steel cables meet the official requirements, they must undergo a final tensile strength test.
这个绳我们要求标准是390，我们实际上达到了450千牛，450千牛就是45吨，看起来25毫米，这么一根细细的钢丝绳，可以相当于吊起45吨这样一个重量的。
Thanks to such rigorous quality control, the Guizhou Steel Rope Group has shifted from importing bridge cables to producing them domestically. In fact, the two 1,908-meter main cables for the Zangke River Bridge were made right here. With their world-leading steel cable manufacturing capabilities, Guizhou has also gained the authority to revise international standards for steel cables, giving Made in China a more robust voice on the global stage. Each steel wire, from the moment the raw material enters the factory, undergoes 5 major processes and 29 minor processes. With each step, the tensile strength and corrosion resistance are enhanced until they meet or exceed the requisite standards.
从直径13毫米，经过各种工序之后呢，会成为直径5.25毫米的钢丝。抗拉强度由原来的1350兆帕增加到2040兆帕，单根钢丝就可以吊起4.5吨的重量。我们的每一根钢丝会经过这样的分线板，最后进入这个六边形排列的这个穿线孔。 最后形成这个正六边形的排列，再经过我们的这个核丝膜，以及我们后面的工装，加上我们的长包带，最终形成一个正六边形的锁骨。我们的这个正六边形，它是一个内蜂窝形的一个结构，它锁骨与锁骨之间贴合更紧密，最后组成一个圆形的主缆。
张克江大桥的单根主缆呢，它是由12809根这样的钢丝组成。
The facility produces the main cables for suspension bridges, the hangers that connect the main cables to the bridge deck, as well as the stays for cable stayed bridges. The Zangke River Bridge will be using self-sealing galvanized, rare earth alloy hangers, produced by the Guizhou Steel Rope Group. Each Z-shaped cross-sectional steel wire is tightly fitted, while the galvanization brings the steel cable's waterproof and corrosion-resistant capabilities to a new level.
这个就是我们全密封钢丝绳的一个断面。从这个断面我们可以看到，中心是由我们原钢丝组成的一个单股钢丝绳，然后外面呢，我们是三圈的这个 Z 型钢丝，环环相扣，成合成紧密贴合在一起，来形成我们的一个密封效果。
Of course, building the world's most advanced bridges requires the highest standards in manufacturing capabilities. Thanks to world-class steel cable manufacturing and locally adapted innovative processes, China now has the confidence to push the limits in suspension and cable-stayed bridge construction. From 720 meters to 800 meters, 1,088 meters, 1,200 meters, and up to the world's longest mountain-spanning bridge at 1,420 meters. China continues to outdo itself year after year. Building bridges in mountainous gorges presents challenges far more complex than in flat or marine environments. The unpredictable winds that funnel through canyons can have potentially catastrophic effects on a bridge. In order to ensure it can endure a century or more of the elements, simulations of intense winds are carried out before construction is complete. At Chang'an University's Wind Tunnel Laboratory, an interesting experiment is about to take place. Using this scale model of the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge, concrete blocks to serve as the surrounding terrain and simulated high winds, Su Xianghua will collect important data that will help determine whether the bridge can withstand extreme weather conditions.
可以现在都可以看出明显的在摆动，也有可能是这样动，像现在这个实验的风是大概是每秒3米左右，相当于它要乘放大系数，就是实际的风，实际桥受到的12级以上风的这种速度了，这些都是会影响桥梁结构安全的，所以我们需要做这么一个风洞实验，来把这个情况模拟了，反过来我在我的设计上。 就来改变它对我的桥的状态，所以我们通过我们的风的试验，我们在这加了这一个扰流板，这个扰流板呢，就是我们的今后体育竞技的一个世界最高桥上的最高的跑道，但是同步它起了一个风对桥的作用，起一个改善的一个效果。However,
wind is just one of the many challenges that engineers will face while attempting to build the world's highest bridge.
世界第一高桥，第一跨第一高，不是我们有意为之，是这个地方地形决定的。一个是花江这儿呢，再往窄的地方走呢，是风景名胜区的核心区，过不去了。然后呢，还有地质原因，原来我们有个桥位只有1300多米。 但是呢，钻探下来那个地质比较破碎，有泄河裂隙，那放在那儿桥就不安全，所以选来选去就选到了这么一个位置，如果我桥低了，必然前后隧道就长了，这个隧道长了，行车舒适性也降低了，所以就一个在经济合理的这个条件下，最后选择了这么一个桥。
While the complex terrain often presents unprecedented challenges, it also provides designers and engineers with a juicy opportunity to flex their creative muscles. Perhaps that's why the bridges of Guizhou are so wonderfully diverse and stand out as some of the world's most impressive man-made structures.
每一个峡谷情况都不一样，能用梁桥，板凳桥尽量用。 然后，如果是板凳桥跨度大了，板凳桥过不去了，才会考虑其他桥型。梁桥最大跨度，我们现在实际上已经可以做到300米了。还有这个地形，如果地形正好是这么一个峡谷地形嘛，适合修拱桥，那么就是拱桥。但是拱桥现在能做到500米左右，也到顶了。那么剩下的能考虑的就是斜拉桥、悬索桥。那么斜拉桥呢，现在山区斜拉桥也就800米左右，也是到极限了。悬索桥的跨越能力最大。
In just a single decade, Guizhou has set and broken several height and length records for its bridges. Even more importantly, during this time, designers, engineers, and construction workers have been given the chance to work on the projects of their dreams, gaining invaluable experience in the process. When height and length no longer pose insurmountable challenges, anything becomes possible. The next goal is minimizing costs while maximizing environmental protection. Since its opening in June 2021, the Huayudong Bridge has strictly adhered to zero pollution maintenance. The bridge deck is regularly cleaned of litter, and wastewater is channeled into sedimentation tanks through special pipelines for purification before being discharged into Hongfeng Lake below, which supplies drinking water to nearly 6 million residents.
那么老桥呢是1991年建成的，它已经满足不了现在的这个交通量和荷载的这样一个需求了，那么要拆除重建。那么拆除重建的时候，我们面临的这样一个比较严苛的环境是，这个位置，是我们贵阳市的这个饮用水源的一级保护区，同时也是国家级的4A级风景区，如何在拆除重建的时候满足我们非常严苛的环境需求？这是考验我们桥梁工程师智慧的时刻。
过去像这种拱桥的这个拆除，那么主要是两种方法，一种就是爆破，一种就是这个支架拆除。爆破的话呢，很简单，整个把它炸到这个湖里面去。但是这个呢，饮用水源和景区，这是坚决不能这样干的。那么我们的想法是，不拆老桥，先建新桥的这两根拱类，然后呢，剩下来这个吊索呢、扣索呢，把这个老桥呢，相当于都在这个新建这个拱类上面，然后再逐根杆件呢，拆除，中层是钢管混凝土提篮拱。为什么叫提篮拱呢？你看这两个拱类啊，两条拱类，它内倾了10度，就特别像我们那个老百姓去买菜的那个提篮。
Using this method, the engineers were able to remove the old bridge and replace it with a new one, creatively solving the pollution issue while shortening construction time and reducing costs. Their innovative approach earned international recognition, winning the Gustav Lindenthal Medal, widely considered to be the Nobel Prize of Bridge Engineering. It's also the smallest bridge ever to win this award. At heights like this, there are always unexpected surprises.
This 鸟窝好大呀！
看上去设计还比较精致。
是啊，它这里是一个洞，然后里面好大个空腔，用了钢丝，用了这么粗的树枝。
对我们这个工程还是比较认可的。
哎，是。看这个鸟窝，这个也不算重，是吧？对咱们这个主体结构也没有太大的影响。我在想，要不咱们就不动它，让它保存原样。
行。
桥梁的设计使用寿命呢是100年，我们人呢基本上活不过100岁。那么我们离开了这个世界以后，这个世界留下了我们设计的桥梁，我们施工的桥梁，世界因我来过而改变，这个就是我们这个职业最大的这个成就感的来源之处。
In March, Hongfeng Lake becomes the world's center of attention because of its cherry blossoms.People carefully tend to this, the world's largest cherry blossom garden, because they understand that only by preserving this beautiful springtime garden do the roads and bridges truly find their purpose.